and welcome. Today is Friday. What does it mean? Well, the weekend is about to start. What does it else mean? Yeah, put on your carry pants and play some games. I did exactly the same in one of my most liked trips, the Duca d'Aosta. Yeah, I know it's not OP, it's not particularly strong, but I don't give a fuck. I love this ship. For some reasons. It's fast, it's agile, it's... Yeah, I wouldn't say nimble. Has a good concealment value. And yeah, unless you're tiered against tier 8, it's doing quite fine, I think. Against tier 8, you have to sit behind islands and spam and so on if you want to make it work. On the other hand, if you end up in a matchup like this, tier 5, tier 6, this is really, really optimal. Even tier 7 is fine for you if you're a kind of competent player. The thing with the Duca is it's a challenge to play. You have little hit points, your armor isn't particularly good, only against cruiser fire. Your DPM isn't outstanding, your AA is more or less crap, you don't have a special hydro, you have only 14 kilometers range. But still, I love the ship. It's challenging to play, and that's why I'm playing it from now on then. And today I thought, okay, I'm playing it. Last game before that game, I had a really, really bad game, but okay, that can happen. I mean, it's not a particularly good carry ship. Alright, so as you saw, two carriers each side, and the enemy carrier is deciding to go for me, so I'm waiting till the last moment when he commits himself, turning away, because I don't want to turn in. Because then I'm closing the distance towards the enemy, and I want to avoid that at the beginning, even though I don't see how many people are there. You see how strong the AA is. I shot down one plane with defensive so far. At least we know that there is a New York now as well. Okay, enemy CV is smart enough to pull his stuff back, while our CV is... losing his fighters. I can tell you that my CVs weren't the best at this game, but I mean, at least I have defensive AA, and it's fine. A necessity for this ship is definitely IFHG. You have poor alpha damage on the HE, and you have on top a poor fire chance. So not particularly a good battleship killer at all. I mean, besides the lacking of range. Alright, so the carrier is coming again. I'm looking for some security nicks to that Pensacola, and he's doing exactly that. He has some way, way stronger AA than I have, and combined we can shoot down the enemy torp bombers. I mean, he shot them down, not myself, but okay. So, a thing you should pay attention to, that you don't go on a lonely trip when you don't have defensive AA active or available. That you should not go away from your team then. Alright, what else to say about the Duca? Oh yeah, it has a nice top armament. It has two triple launchers each side with 12 kilometer slowly moving torps, and I have to say I love them. They have a really little reload time. That's why you can just literally spam them wherever you want, wherever you you expect the enemy to go. Don't expect hits, but it can be a nuisance for the enemy. They are not quite hard to dodge, so... The strengths of the Duca, though, are in kind of close quarter fights against enemy cruisers and DDs. You have, as you see, two consumables active. or available, sorry, active, my god, hydro, acoustic and defensive AA. So you can, you're kind of a designated DD killer. Not so much a BB killer. I mean, of course, with IFHE you can do your thing, and with the spotter plane you can extend your range to, what is it, 16.8, which isn't massive, but it works. But you know, by now you should know that I hate playing with spotter plane and shooting with spotter plane. And yeah, you see my efficiency here. This New Mexico is 14 kilometers away now, and I still don't hit much. My carrier is going off for him, so it throws off my aim completely. These arcs have the tendency, these shells have also the tendency of losing a lot of speed over longer distances. They are pretty fast in closer to mid range, because they are at, I think, 1000 meters per second. So this is, especially the AP, it lacks penetration on the distance, but if you come into close quarter fights, which you will see, little spoil, later in this game, pretty handy. And you have a 7.5 second reload, so it's doable. As I said, you have only 8 guns, but and your DPM isn't the greatest. I mean, Nürnberg's out DPM, you probably, nah, but Johnny should be the same. Yeah, but of course you need to get rid of the battleships. Clearly on tier 6 they are always extending a lot, and you don't have to worry too much about it. And of course you can also compensate a lot by dodging. Of course, and also you can expect to get penetrated whenever they hit you, because your armor isn't strong, as I said before. Alright, this battle is evolving. My northern side here is absolutely collapsing. Right now we are one ship behind, not so significant yet, but I also noticed that my CVs are not the best among the CV community, so to say. My only fire I set on the on the New Mexico killed him, so I'm fine with that. So my goal is here now to go for that smoke. I know that there is emerald in there, and also on top the Fushun. And since I have hydro and I have this really really good AP, I can maybe sneak myself on. And also I want to try to help my Normandy here, putting up the hydro in case there are some torps throwing going his way, which is pretty important, and I want to help my Normandy. I don't know if it's if it has the range, but still, what you have, right? And also, I mean, it shows when this guy is shooting and probably detected. Yeah, that's an issue. As I said, this southern part here of the team absolutely crumbled. This Oba is there for whatever reason. And now I get attacked by the CV and have to show broadside to the Emerald, but in this case that's not even close fight for me. We all know Emeralds, they just get murdered by any decent not even decent, I mean every time you shoot at them. In the battleship they can't angle, and that's the story about it. Alright, switching back to HE because I'm still in the spotting range of the Fushun. Alerta rientrata per gli operatori della contraerea. Throwing some torps where I expect him to stop. I know that there will there it is. But I'm focusing on the Ober here. He's showing me a lot of broadside, so that's of course what I'm doing. There we go, that's the first citadel. He has the damage con to get his control working, throwing another volley of torps into the smoke, hoping the best. course, I'm trying to gain some distance now. And angle myself in case he realizes that he can also shoot AP, but he is sticking to HE, which is smart because I wouldn't give him any broadside whatsoever. Incrociatore nemico affondato. If I can avoid it. But of course, the 203 mils HE damage are paying his dues, their dues, and yeah, that's why I'm down to 7k. Or even closer. That are the Obertorps, they have range, need to avoid them. And just run for now. I wanna get undetected. It's quite hard, but okay. Pensacola also behind there. I mean, as I said, against cruisers, if you know what you're doing, you're doing quite fine, in my opinion. That was a bad volley. He turned in time. Launching my spotter plane to get maybe some additional spotting. But you see, enemy CV is just keeping me spotted all the time. Just throwing some torps. Maybe some of the DVs are hind there. So T-22 is opening fire. Questionable decision by him. His HE isn't particularly good. If he wanna should have opened fire, then only with AP. He can hurt me with that, but I guess he doesn't know. I'm stopping here, I don't wanna gain more distance, I'm not so afraid of him. Seems as if he has last stand, it's quite hard sometimes to estimate the speed. But he is smart enough to go dark. Fujun spotted, of course, I'm taking a shot, even though on 10 kilometers I'm confident. I think that's still in range when the shells are still quick enough. Yep. Every hit is a good hit. Meanwhile, my team is running from this our cap. I don't know why, but okay. It is at least the case. And there's the next issue. He's smoking up and the T-22 can spot me. And if he's knowing what he's doing, the Fujun is pretty, pretty strong when it comes to shooting low HP targets. And I just popped Hydro just because of that case. I was worried about some torps. Siluria dritta. But I realize, well, if you want to win this game, I need to take out these destroyers. They are just killing my battleships, and somehow my CB doesn't seem to have any planes left, and my Podwalski is somewhere over the rainbow. So I'm trying to minimize the playground for this T-22 and pushing him away. He overextended, and yeah, just run into me. Now he's an easy prey for me. As I said, I'm not fearing T-22's guns. Smoking doesn't help because you're in my hydro range. Thing is, my aim or my dispersion isn't the best as well. But there we go. Alright, so now the spotting issue is solved. Latest ships spotted here were Fushun and Fubuki. So what do I think about them? Yeah, well, what would a tier 6 player do? He would go into the cap circle, right? And exactly that's what I'm assuming and also heading this way. The fact that I'm not spotted means that they are around in this area here. And as I said, I'm just throwing torps. I don't mind. I can throw as many as I want. Maybe they hit at some point. So far, I'm at 4 kills. And I keep going. Okay, the fact that I'm spotted right now knows tells me that they are around here now. I'm going this way now, and as soon as I see that this this covered sign is changing, I know that I got torped, and then. Oh yeah, that Fujun made a critical error. That was critical. You don't want to do this. That's way too close. I mean, and now he is doing another crucial mistake. I think one more volley would have killed me. But he decided, and that's for sure, I am pretty aware of that, that he taught me. So I'm gaining some distance. Since I... Fusion Torps aren't the fastest. And he had to predict how fast I'm going. I was in a turn, so I was slower there. And now I went straight line. Yeah, exactly, and I can avoid them. So if he aimed just for the marker. And maybe a bit ahead. So, Fubuki is dead in the water. But my dispersion is not really favoring me. Nope. And there we come to the poor HE damage. Which, not even one hit kills him, and the Congo secures this kill sadly. Alright, I know from now on it's just like, okay, let's move ahead. I just carried my team again. I mean, they weren't so bad. I mean, most of them survived all the stuff. And now they are still quite healthy, because the enemy DDs were too stubborn of getting the cap instead of torping my ships, which helped me to kill them. And now it's just about like farming this independence. And I managed to get my 6th kill. And had a really, really fun game, even though it was on the edge at some point when I was like really worried when I had only like little HP left. But in the end, I made it and I'm really glad. So that's the Duca. A fun little ship for everyone that likes to play challenging ships. It's never a thing for a newbie, that's for sure. Someone who's not experienced in cruiser play at all will not have any fun with the ship. And it's all sometimes a lot of work to make it work, I have to say. And don't expect high damage games. I think my highest I have it also on the channel was around like 140-50k. And that's what you achieve like once in a while, but not really often. More like 50-60k. And this one is also a bit higher than my average, I guess. Yeah, 2.25 base XP is quite a good value, I think. I mean, I killed almost all of their DDs. Yeah. And it's only tier 5, tier 6, so I was top tier. I guess a pretty, pretty good result for that. And yeah, if you check AP to HE values, if you can shoot AP on close ranges, always do it. Flat broadsides on battleships, cruisers, that's the thing you want to go for. AA, in the end I shot still 11 planes down, I have no clue how, but yeah, that probably pops the value of, or pops the the base XP also a bit higher. Yeah, that's it for most likely. Yeah, nothing else to add. So yeah, hope you have a good start in your weekend. If you like this video, just give it a like. If you have to, if you want to comment on this, just comment on this. And yeah, see you next time. Bye bye.